Parshat Yitro, there's so much to discuss. The whole idea of the Aseret HaDibrot, which we loosely translate as the Ten Commandments, but that's not what the Hebrew means. Aseret HaDibrot. It doesn't mean the Ten Suggestions, but it doesn't mean the Ten Commandments. It means the Ten Statements. Exactly how many commandments are in these? Is the first introductory, I am the Lord your God, a commandment? Or is it a introduction to the rest of the commandments? Are all the commandments found in the Aseret HaDibrot? These are conversations, please God, we'll have together over the course of many years together. I'd like to focus today just on one sentence that happens after receiving the Aseret HaDibrot, the 10 statements or 10 plus commandments or so. And that is, it says, V'chol ha'am ro'im et ha'kolot ve'et ha'lapidim. And all of the people see the sounds. The commentaries point out seeing sounds is a miracle. And there were a lot of miracles that happened at Mount Sinai, including the ability to see sounds, including the fact that at Mount Sinai, all those that had challenges hearing and others who had other challenges were overcome on Mount Sinai. And it's for that reason that actually hospitals throughout the world are called Mount Sinai after these midrashic statements. However, the ancient commentary, the Targum Yonatan ben Uziel, on the words V'chol ha'am ro'im et ha'kolot, has a beautiful concept. Although it is ancient when it was scribed, it is so relevant to us in this day and age. V'chol ha'am ro'im et ha'kolot, according to the Targum Yonatan ben Uziel, is that everyone found their own sound, saw their own path. And even though the Torah was given to all of the Jewish people, ki ish echad b'lev echad, in one unified fashion, everyone found their own portal of entry. Everyone found their own music, their own space, their own sound. What an important message. The way we treat our children the same is to realize that they're different, that they hear different sounds, that different components of the Jewish experience speak to them. The way we treat other people respectfully, the way we treat other Jews respectfully, is to realize that each of us looks at Judaism and connects to different aspects of Judaism. V'chol ha'am ro'im et ha'kolot ve'et ha'lapidim. And that's why it pains me when we hear leaders challenge the authenticity of Jews. When leaders speak about Soviet Jews or Ethiopian Jews as not Jewish, even if there are halachic challenges, but ro'im et ha'kolot, they are searching for their sounds, they're searching for their space. And so many of us, you know, spend time protesting to let the Soviet Jews out of the former Soviet Union. Now we have to ro'im et ha'kolot. We don't have to let our people go, we have to let our people know. We have to find ways in which every Jew and every human being can find ro'im et ha'kolot, can find their spiritual space. Please God, we will re-accept the Luchot, the Ten Commandments, so to say. Each and every one of us will find our own space, will find our own music, and will allow others to find their own music within the parameters of Jewish tradition, so that we can engage God in ways that allow us to create a symphony of conversations between us as a people and our beloved engagement with God. Shabbat Shalom.